Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, hi, my name's Lavinia, and I post beauty videos regarding makeup and skincare every Tuesday, Friday, and Sunday at 8 a.m. Mountain Standard Time. So if that's something you're interested in, I'd love for you to join my channel by hitting the big red subscribe button. So as you can tell by the title, today we're gonna be testing out some new skincare, and we're gonna be trying out the new Yes to Tomato collection. And yes, you heard me right, tomatoes. All these products are formulated with antioxidant rich tomato extract and detoxifying charcoal to help with blemishes, breakouts, and all of that fun stuff. And if you don't know, I have dry sensitive acne prone skin, so I do break out quite often, and any type of skincare product that can help me with that, I'm willing to try. So they did send these to me. But of course we're going to have to put them to the test and really see if they're any good. So if you want to see me review the new Yes to Tomato skincare collection, just keep on watching.
Oh, you tell me stories, you tuck me in, and the second you leave, I call you right back to check for monsters.
So I think I'm gonna go like one by one, since we do have a lot of products. I'm gonna go through like the information on one of them, try it, information on another, try it, so on and so forth. So first is the Yes to Tomatoes Daily Scrub and Cleanser, and this is formulated with charcoal to detoxify, and it's for blemish prone skin. So I have all the information here on my laptop from their website that we're going to take a look at. This is supposed to help balance oily skin. I do not have oily skin. I do have dry skin, so I'm interested to see how this works on my skin as well. But the charcoal in here is supposed to detoxify and draw impurities. And there's also biodegradable jojoba spheres to gently exfoliate. There's also a medicated dose of BHA salicylic acid in here. It says 1% in the ingredients, which I think is a good amount. The maximum amount of salicylic acid you can have is 2%. So 1% in a cleanser, I would say, is pretty good. So this is made of 97% natural ingredients. It's cruelty-free, dermatologist-tested, vegan, formulated without parabens and silicones, and also non-comedogenic. And looking at the ingredients, as I said, we have salicylic acid, charcoal, tomato extract, which is really what I'm excited to see. It's supposed to be a natural source of antioxidants to help balance oily skin. There is a bit of fragrance in here, which I don't mind in a cleanser, since you keep it on for like 5 seconds anyways. So let's head on to my bathroom and try out this cleanser. Welcome to my bathroom, and I have the cleanser here. So it is dark, probably from the charcoal. This smells very like fresh, like a fresh soap kind of. So you can definitely see those like jojoba beads in there, but nothing too harsh. Oh, and it kind of foams up a little bit. It's definitely very fragranced. It just smells like a body wash almost, or like a hand soap. I probably will only use this once a day, so it's not too much exfoliating going on. And like these little jojoba spheres, they're not like those harsh, scratchy exfoliators that you feel in like a scrub. They're just more like massaging in a way, if that makes sense. I'm just going to rinse it off now. So here's what my skin looks like after cleansing. I will say it feels very clean, no dry spots or anything. So I feel like it did a good job lightly exfoliating without being too sensitive. And it doesn't feel that tight right now, which is good, because a lot of foaming cleansers will dry out my skin. This one didn't feel too stripping. So far, first impression wise, I think it's pretty good. All right, so now that my skin is cleansed, we can move on to the next product, which I believe is going to be the Daily Blemish Toner. It's supposed to clarify by helping to fight the appearance of any blemishes. It's formulated with 10% fruit acid, AHA and BHAs, salicylic acid, witch hazel, tea tree oil, and natural detoxifying benefits of the charcoal as well. Witch hazel I'm a little bit iffy on, just because it can be a little sensitive for me, but we'll have to see. If there's not like a high amount of it, then it might be pretty good. Looking at the ingredient list, it is lower down, so it might be fine. We do have fragrance in here, which I'm a bit iffy on, but again, if it doesn't sensitize my skin, then I'm fine with it. We'll just have to see. All right, so let's get to applying this. It says to use a cotton pad, press down on the pump twice, and just swipe it across your face after cleansing. you should experience a tingling sensation with some redness, but not too much. It says to allow this to absorb and use it 1 to 2 times a week until your skin becomes used to it. After that, you can use it twice daily. So just kind of listen to your skin. I don't actually like using cotton pads for my toners. I know I'm weird like that. So I'm just going to use my hand and pump it. Okay, we got a lot of product. So you definitely don't need 2 pumps with doing it just in your hand, because a lot comes out. I'm just gonna take some of this, and I like to just pat it in. I can't really smell the fragrance that much, but it does smell a little bit perfumey for sure. I'm gonna go down the neck too. Not really feeling that tingliness too much is a good sign. I'm just a little worried about the fragrance, but we'll have to see. All right, next product, we have the Detoxifying Overnight Moisturizer with Salicylic Acid. This is supposed to be applied to cleanse skin, and it will basically detoxify because of that charcoal, and then has salicylic acid of 0.5% in here to help with the acne. It's an overnight treatment that goes to work while you sleep, helping to prevent new acne from forming and replenishing the moisture that may have stripped away. That sounds absolutely amazing, because I do oftentimes struggle with a stripped moisture barrier, so anything that can help with that, I like. There is also alcohol in here, but it is lower down on the list, and then fragrance again. So this is what the product looks like right here. And then I'm just going to pump some out. Hello
there.
Okay, I finally got it to pump out. That took so long. The moisturizer does have a gray color to it, so we'll have to see how this works. It feels like a nice consistency. A little bit of that same perfumey fragrance in there, but let's see. This is like absorbing really fast. I've never tried a moisturizer with salicylic acid, so I'm definitely intrigued, but so far my skin feels nice and moisturized. So the next product we have to try is the Zip Zapping Dots. These are basically just blemish stickers, and we have quite a few spots to work with today. This comes with 24 dots. They're all in here. We have the red ones and the black ones. So these are supposed to help with blemishes because they have salicylic acid in them and the tomato extract. So the black and red dots are equally effective. That's why I went sick. So it says make sure the skin is wet or the dot will not stick. I have a water bottle. I'm just gonna take a bit of water and place it right on top of the pimple. Let's try some of the black ones too. And last one I'm gonna put over here. So I'm going to keep these on for the 8 to 10 hours, and I'll see you guys then. All right guys, so it's been quite a couple hours since I've had these on. I will say that this one is really stubborn and just wouldn't stay on, so I'm gonna have to kind of get used to how to actually apply these properly. But let's go ahead and remove them. So there's nothing really on it, but I feel like the pimple is a lot more to the surface now. All right, so I'm going to continue using these skincare products over in the next few days. Hey guys, so it is the next day. I just finished doing my skincare routine. I applied the cleanser. The only thing that I'm just not loving about right now is how fragranced it is. Same with the toner. But I am really liking this moisturizer so far. I do think it's really, really nice since it's so lightweight. You know, absorbs into the skin really fast and isn't too heavy. And a lot of like overnight moisturizers I feel like are super heavy, greasy, all of that, but this one's super light, and I feel like all skin types would like this. I have dry skin, it keeps my skin very moisturized, but I feel like even if you have oily skin, this would be nice, and the fact that it's an acne treatment at the same time is really cool. So I did have a second friend come out over here. I do feel like this one though doesn't hurt as much after using the patches yesterday, but this one was under the skin and I feel like these might have just brought it out. So we're gonna use these again today. I am going to do this right this time. So I'm going to wet this whole area. And I'm gonna take the patch and apply it on. I've never tried acne patches that are like water activated, but they're on right now, and I'll see you guys when I'm gonna take them off. All right guys, so it's the end of the day and it's now time to remove these. So we actually do have some stuff on there. Still a whitehead, but I will say it does hurt a lot less than it did this morning, which is good. And this one, there we go. And this one does hurt a lot less too. So they're definitely doing something. I'm gonna go ahead and continue with this routine. Gonna do my night routine, apply all the products, reapply some of these patches, and I'll update you guys later. All right guys, we've reached the end of the week. So now it's time to talk about my final thoughts on the Yes to Tomato products. I'm gonna review these products from my least favorite to my most favorite. So we're gonna start off with the toner, the Daily Blemish Toner. This one I found was a little too fragrant for my liking. And since I have such sensitive skin, I just found that this was maybe being a little bit irritating to my skin and potentially overstripping it, since it is more formulated for oily skin. So, you know, having that witch hazel in there might have just been a little too much for my skin to handle. So, didn't love this, but I definitely could see how someone with oily skin would maybe benefit from it. Just for me personally, it didn't work out. Next product I want to talk about is the Daily Scrub and Cleanser. I really like the idea of this having, you know, those little gel beads in there that are lightly going to exfoliate the skin without scratching or scraping or harming your skin in any way. So I did like that it's kind of like a two-in-one and you get that light exfoliation every time you use it. The only thing I didn't love about this cleanser is all the fragrance in it. It's really potent. As much as I don't mind fragrance in a cleanser, if you're sensitive to scents in general, this is a pretty strong smell. I just want to put that out there. But as a cleanser, I think it cleansed great. My skin always felt really refreshed after it and really glowy due to those light exfoliation beads. So honestly, I do think it's a pretty good cleanser and it did what it was supposed to do. Next, I want to talk about the detoxifying overnight moisturizer. I had never tried a product like this where it's going to be a moisturizer, but just help your acne so much. I definitely think this is the reason or part of the reason that my breakouts went down so much, because you guys can see my skin right now. All those actives I had at the beginning of the week are kind of gone now, or close to gone, and I do think that this really just dried up my acne so good. But the only thing I will say is my skin did feel a little bit more oily in the time that I was using this, because I think it might have been stripping my skin a little bit too much, since I do have such dry skin and this is more formulated for oily skin. But also because it has salicylic acid in there, it is going to be more drying and stripping. So I think I will still continue to use this, but maybe more as a spot treatment, or I'll kind of layer it with one of my other moisturizers to kind of still get that super moisturizing feel out of it. But I loved how this felt on the skin. It blended into the skin really nicely and was super lightweight. Didn't feel too heavy at all for an overnight moisturizer, and it really worked to diminish my acne, or you know, keep it on a low for this week. So I think I'll definitely use it more as a spot treatment, like where I usually get pimples, like here on my mouth, or if I have a breakout, maybe I'll concentrate it there. But I think for me, all over the face, it might be too much, especially on a daily basis. But if I were to use this, maybe if my skin was really having a freak out and I were to use this all over my skin for one night, that I think would be a lot better than using it daily. So kind of using this in moderation for myself with my dry skin is definitely how I think it would be best for me. Now, for my favorite product in the line would be the Yes to Tomato Zip Zapping Dots. I actually really enjoyed these. It took me a while to kind of get used to them, since I had never used one of these acne dots. I needed water to kind of get it to stick to your face, and the first few times I used them, they were kind of slipping and sliding and they weren't adhering right, but I definitely think I got the hang of it towards the end. So you just want to make sure you apply, you know, some water, dampen the face where you're going to apply this, put it on, and then don't move it. It will kind of slip and slide since it is wet, but after it kind of clings on, it's there to stay. And what I really like these is they didn't have like a strong adhesive to them as most acne patches do, and that adhesive can actually sensitize your skin or cause you to break out even more sometimes. So I did like that there's no really adhesive to this and they're kind of water activated. I found that really cool, and I also really enjoyed that these actually worked on my under the skin pimples too. Like I had one here that I applied it to, which was under the skin, hadn't reached the surface yet, and it like diminished it so much under the skin and it didn't hurt anymore. So I really enjoyed that, because usually these pimple patches are more used for surface acne. So the fact that I could use it on my like hormonal cysts was really cool as well, and I definitely think they worked. I also will say that they just shrunk down my pimples so much during the day, and I think, you know, they have beneficial ingredients in here to really just help, like, diminish the size of pimples. Like, this one right here was huge at the beginning of the week, and now it's basically just a scar. So I think these definitely worked really well. They're definitely one of my favorite new acne patches to use. They're really easy to use. You can use them like day and night. They're not oversensitizing. They don't have that adhesive in there to sensitize your skin. They work on under the skin pimples and surface acne, big zits, small zits, whatever it is. These I just really, really enjoyed. So they definitely helped with healing my acne this week. Also, if you're interested in any of the products I mentioned in today's video, they will all be linked down below in the description. All right, guys, so that's it for this video. That's all my thoughts on the new Yes to Tomatoes skincare line. If you want to see more videos like this, my whole skincare playlist will be linked down below in the description. But if you did enjoy, please give this video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already. Also, make sure to turn on my post notifications so you get notified every single time I upload a new video. And yeah, guys, I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Oh, you tell me stories.